everyone. Welcome back to the Strong Sistas YouTube channel. And today we're going to be talking about carbs on carnivore. But before we get started, I'd like to bring something up that Danny Vega likes to say all the time, which is carbs are not for everyone. So the discussion of carbs is really going to change depending on your goals and your activity levels. If your number one and two priorities are healing or weight loss, I would not suggest carbs. Carbs are just going to complicate things. And following a strict carnivore diet is gonna help you reach your goals a lot sooner. But if you are relatively lean and pretty active and push yourself hard in the gym and are looking to use carbs to enhance your gym performance and get absolutely huge, you've come to the right place. So let's dive in.
Okay, so when it comes to using carbs to enhance performance, you're gonna wanna consider three different things. One, when to consume the carbs. Two, what carbs you're consuming. And three, how much carbs. How many carbs, how many grams of carbs you're using.
And for carb timing, there's obviously three options: pre-workout, inter-workout, and post-workout. And we encourage everyone to try each of those and see where they feel the best. Sarah and I don't like pre for a few reasons. First off, there's some interesting science from Dr. Bullock's lab, which showed that fat-adapted athletes and carb-fueled athletes have the same level of muscle glycogen. And what that means is you're not gonna walk into the gym with flat muscles. Like, my shoulders aren't gonna be flat and deflated walking into the gym, so I should have relatively good energy walking into the gym. So I personally don't feel as much benefit when I have carbs pre-workout. Another reason is we feel super bloated when we have carbs pre-workout. That may be a function of us drinking too much water before our lifts. So if you do try pre-workout carbs and haven't had carbs in a while, we definitely suggest do not have as much liquids, because we get bloated, we don't feel as good in the gym, and then the carbs are almost pointless because we can't push ourselves as much. So Dr. Bullock's study shows that athletes that are fat fueled undergo some metabolic adaptations that allow them to create muscle glycogen through gluconeogenesis. And as a note, that study was performed for endurance athletes. I would like to see a few more studies performed on strength, powerlifting, bodybuilding type athletes. And that brings us to intra-workout carbs, which is my favorite carb source. I've actually got some carbs in this water bottle right here that I will drink throughout my workout. So I like to drink and consume carbs after my main movement. So the way that my lifting routines are organized is I have like a main strength movement, like squats, deadlift, bench. Today I had high bar squats, 4x6, and it was super hard. And then I have a super intense workout after that. So it's like a power building approach where I've got a strength movement and then just intense bodybuilding the rest of the lift. So I like to start to consume my carbs after that main movement, so that way I can have good energy to finish off the rest of my lift strong. So that Bullock study, which showed equal muscle glycogen levels, I'd love to see the muscle glycogen levels in the middle of a workout, because I personally feel like my muscle glycogen levels dip after that main movement and I start to feel a little bit tired after that main movement. And then when I consume some carbs, I have some instant energy that I can use to fuel the rest of my lift, and I can continue to push myself super hard. Because when it comes down to building muscle, two important things. One, are you consuming enough protein? And two, are you increasing that training stimulus? These intra-workout carbs help me increase that training stimulus so that my muscles can go. So I just finished up my main movement, which was squats and also my hip thrusts, and I'm sipping on some keto super carb from Archetype Supplements. It's gonna help me fuel the rest of my lift. And that brings us to post-workout carbs, which I think can be a great tool, but not used every single day, not every single lift. I think once in a while, and use them on after your days where you really push yourself in the gym. Reason for this, I think that consuming some post-workout carbs can help you replenish those muscle glycogen stores. I'm just walking around the gym, sitting in new spots to record more parts of this video. This brings us to question number two. How many carbs should I consume? So what I drank during the workout, my intra-workout carbs, that was only 15 grams of carbs. And to me, that's plenty. I don't need any more during the lift. And if I use post-workout carbs, I'll typically stick to like 40 grams of carbs. I really don't feel like you need that much. I know some people who use a little bit more. Honestly, experiment, see, try to find that tipping point where if you go above that level, you start to feel like crap. And again, we don't do this that often. We choose to do it after really intense lower body days, like at the end of a blocker cycle when we're really starting to feel a little bit down, tired. You know what I'm saying. New gym location, and that brings us to question number 3, which is what type of carb should I use? So studies in sports performance have actually shown that using a carb blend, so for example, a fructose and glucose blend, is actually going to lead to the most amount of performance improvement. And that's because different types of carbs have different intestinal transporters for absorption. What this means is that your carb usage and oxidation is going to be improved. So that's why I'm a huge fan of honey, because it is a mixture of fructose and glucose. So for intra-workout carb, I recommend trying honey and the Keto Supercarb from Architect Supplements. For post-workout, again, experiment to find what works best for you. But when Sarah and I do post-workout carbs, we like to choose some of the most benign carb sources. And what do we mean by benign? Basically, carb sources have the least amount of anti-nutrients, phytoestrogens, things that are gonna cause issues in our guts. So our favorite benign carb sources are things like avocado, so non-sweet fruits, and then you've got members of the Cucurbita, I don't know how to pronounce it properly, but it's like squash, pumpkin, zucchini, cucumbers. Those are relatively benign if you remove the skin and the seeds. And then we also like to use rice every once in a while. So rice is going to have arsenic, which is a heavy metal. And the way you can reduce the arsenic level is by cooking it in extra water and then also choosing brands that are known to have lower arsenic levels, such as Lundberg, and use their basmati or jasmine rice. And then also, fun fact, sushi rice has super low arsenic levels. All right, so that about wraps up this video. In summary, view carbs as a tool or a supplement. We like to say view carbs like a lifting belt. So don't rely on your lifting belt. Be able to operate and perform without it. And then the lifting belt or carbs can be used intelligently to enhance your performance. And I hope the biggest takeaway is to experiment to find what works for you, because what works for someone else isn't necessarily going to work for you. We all have different guts, and we're all going to be able to handle different carb sources and different carb amounts differently. It's going to depend on the amount of muscle mass that you have, the relative amount of intensity that you go through in your workouts, and your current goals. If you're really pushing yourself in the gym, carbs are a super useful tool to allow you to move to the next level, enhance your performance. It's time to get out of here. So I'm gonna bundle up and go home to make a bump in plata. Cause let's heal. But thank y'all for tuning in. If you guys are interested in learning a little bit more about how Sarah and I experimented, check out our targeted carnivore diet, TCD experiments. Videos from earlier this year where we experimented with a bunch of different types of carbs. And just as a final note, Sarah and I just opened up an Etsy store where we have our Let's Eat Yo, Strong Sisters, Eat Big to Lift Big, many other of the crazy things that we say on Instagram. And if you guys don't follow us on Instagram, check out strong.sisters. And until our next video, guys, make sure you behave like an angel.